Good morning. Thanks for joining us to discuss Whisper. I'll start with a quick overview of Whisper before taking you through our FY20 performance, our first year as a listed company. I'll also detail the key growth drivers for our business, including the long-term digital transformational trend. I'll finish with our growth strategy and expectations for FY21. And of course, you have opportunities to ask questions in the Q&A room. Next slide. Whisper is a communication workflow platform that automates interactions between organizations and people to ensure stakeholders receive accurate, timely, and useful insights through the channels those stakeholders prefer to use. We simplify the management of the complex communications ecosystem. The need for our services is universal across industry sectors and countries, and is only increasing as organizations shift to more remote operations and digital business processes, or the digitization of business processes. We're now producing 1.5 billion interactions for our 630 blue chip customers and their 55 million unique stakeholders each year. We've demonstrated product market fit with 11,000 use cases across 60 countries, and we're servicing this global client base from our 10 offices in three regions, 24/7, 365 days a year. Next slide. While our platform enables our customers to solve thousands of complex communications challenges, it's primarily used for business coordination to internal stakeholders, enhanced customer engagement, and crisis communications. It utilizes data-driven insights to deliver contextually relevant and personalized engagement with stakeholders at scale and across multiple delivery channels. On the left, you see the traditional way of delivering these services. They're not channel agnostic. They're hard to build, expensive, take time. Adoption rates are patchy, and they suffer from rapid app abandonment. On the right, you see how the Whisper automated workflow platform allows interactions with stakeholders at the right time, on the right device, with useful and actionable information. In the new normal, our platform is increasingly being used to facilitate digital transformation within organizations. It does this by automating manual processes and improving customer engagement through digital channels. I'll provide more detail on this later. Next slide. Our customers tell us that our proven communications experience over two decades, combined with our low-code, no-code capability, on-demand capability and easy integration with existing IT systems are real differentiators for us. We have a long-term product roadmap strategy, and we're investing in the development of innovative new communications technologies and enhanced platform intelligence to ensure we're able to keep meeting our customers' evolving needs. Add to that, fast development capability, cost-effective infrastructure and service delivery, repeatability and reliable process automation that the platform offers, and you have a formidable product that can scale to address our global market opportunity. Next slide. We partner with established local brands to cost-effectively acquire new customers and enter new markets. Channel partners collectively account for around 3/4 of our revenue and are key to our go-to-market strategy in all three regions. You can see our key channel partners listed here. Telstra is our main channel partner in Australia, while in Asia we have telcos StarHub and Indosat. In the US, our channel partners are more contemporary and include AWS, Vonage, and Nexmo. They all have complementary strengths that we can harness, leading to more diverse sales opportunities and revenue streams. Next slide. We're targeting a significant global market opportunity with our communications workflow platform. The communications platform as a service, or CPaaS market, is growing at a CAGR of 35%. A WCaaS market, which management believe is similar, will reach 8 billion in 4 years. We're continuing to invest in platform innovation and people to ensure the company can scale to capitalize on this market opportunity. Next slide. Moving to our financial performance in FY20. In our first year as a listed company, we met or outperformed all key FY20 prospectus forecasts. Annualized recurring revenue is a key metric for our SaaS business model, providing future revenue surety. In FY20, our ARR increased 34% year on year from 31.5 million in FY19 to 42.2 million at June 2020. Revenues of 39.1 million were up 25.5% on the same period last year, with Asia and Australasia being the main growth drivers, with revenues up 44 and 24% respectively. While the majority of this revenue growth came from our existing customer base, increased demand for communication software for COVID-19 and digital transformation projects delivered record net new customer growth in the second half of FY20. This brings total customer numbers to just over 630. The key to these new customer wins has been our ability to quickly deploy communications capabilities, often within a matter of hours. As well as changing buying behaviours with faster decisions and reduced red tape, it's important to note that these new customers have yet to have a material impact on revenues and ARR. Other financial highlights include EBITDA improved 50% over FY19 and was 2.1 million ahead of prospectus forecasts. Gross margins were in line with expectations at 62.5%. Next slide. Our business is built on strong underlying recurring revenue streams with customer revenue retention of 24.1%. Best in class. As you can see, our customers are generally long-term and doing more with our platform at an ever-increasing rate. While our new customers typically implement Whisper to solve a single communications challenge, once they begin using our software, we become embedded in their operational processes and they use the platform for other use cases. I'll show you an example of that shortly. Next slide. This slide shows the impact to monthly recurring revenues when customers implement more use cases. Each row shows how we've increased average spend for each customer cohort over the last four reporting periods. The second and third rows highlight how we're increasing the number of high-value customers who are using the platform for more use cases. You'll see the number of customers using the platform for four or more use cases has increased 93% since the start of FY19, while the average monthly recurring revenue of these higher value customers has also increased significantly, with year-on-year growth of 47% to just over 23,000 per customer per month. Next slide. George Weston Foods is a good example of a customer who has significantly increased their platform usage over the past few years. George Weston Foods started using Whisper for business continuity planning in 2017. Since then, the use cases have increased almost tenfold as the company fast-tracked their digitization plans to streamline operational processes over the last year. Among the new use cases are product shortage notifications, company updates, HR check-ins, and remote and lone worker. The experience of George Weston Foods is not a one-off. Over the last few months, we've seen years-long digital transformation roadmaps for our customers compressed into months and quarters in order to adapt to the new normal as a result of COVID-19. Next slide. These macro communication trends provide significant short and long-term growth opportunities for Whisper. For many years, businesses have not had urgency when it came to going digital. However, COVID-19 and more remote operations has now made it a necessity. It's evolved from a small tick box on a balanced scorecard to a top business priority. Many companies have shifted their focus to digital transformation and are looking for solutions that are capable of embedding intelligence into business operations, automating more effective operational processes, and transforming their engagement with staff, customers, and their communities, much like what we saw with George Weston Foods. Companies are increasing their digital transformation budgets, with projects being accelerated by years. Next slide. Digital transformation has become the primary driver of productivity, automating manual processes and streamlining business operations. In addition to cost savings, this automation enables more effective use of resources and lowers the risk of user error. Traditional call center operations are increasingly incorporating digital streams to improve response times and redirect call volumes. Next slide. As one of the largest life insurance companies in Asia, AIA Group Singapore leveraged our workflow automation capabilities to digitize its customer communications. Around 60% of its more than 16 million members now receive notifications and e-statements electronically through Whisper, significantly reducing the company's reliance on paper-based communications. AIA's use of Whisper to send contextually relevant and personalized electronic communications to customers has increased engagement, with the platform now used by multiple AIA teams and business units for a range of communications, including customer feedback and Net Promoter Score automation. Next slide. The COVID-19 crisis makes what we thought would be a future digital world a challenge for organizations to address today. Digital channels are becoming the main, in some cases, the sole customer engagement model. Leveraging our technology, our customers are able to utilize data-driven insights to improve their customer experience with faster response times and a consistent brand experience across multiple communications channels. Our easy-to-use software is generating substantial value for our customers, delivering superior business outcomes and improving customer retention ratios and user satisfaction. Next slide. Singapore Telco M1 is a good example of a customer who used Whisper to transform its customer communications structure and automate internal and quite complex sign-off processes. This digitization enabled M1 to standardize its customer communications, improve response times, and enhance its customer targeting capabilities. M1's digital transformation using Whisper increased customer engagement levels from 20% to 80%. Next slide. The next slide shows the digital size, or shows the size of the global digital transformation market, which is growing at a CAGR of 22.5% and is expected to hit US $1.4 trillion by 2027. Digital transformation is an enduring trend and already accounts for the majority of global information and technology investment. It will continue to drive Whisper's platform utilization for many customers and for many years to come. Next slide. To address these significant market opportunities, we're investing heavily in platform innovation and increasing our data-driven intelligence capabilities. Our five-year product roadmap will see us build real defensible intellectual property in Whisper, grounded on three key concepts: prediction, detection, and automation. Prediction is where we build features that can see around corners to save our customers wasted effort. We can use prediction to stop our customers sending messages to people about trains being late if the recipient isn't catching a train that day. Detection is about seeing something as it happens and helping customers avoid making mistakes, such as detecting if a message is poorly written or has a spelling mistake before they send it. And finally, automation. Increased automation will enable our customers to extract value faster. This includes automating the setup of accounts, on the onboarding process, message sending and receiving, leveraging off our powerful workflows. New products are being introduced to include conversational messaging, smart scheduling, intelligent message design capabilities, as well as significantly improved insights into individual recipient preferences. Next slide. Turning to our growth strategy, we have many growth drivers in place to increase our market penetration. We continue to utilize our established channel partners to cost-effectively acquire new customers and expand our footprint in ANZ, Asia, and North America. We're continuing to diversify our channel partners to increase our product offering and drive platform adoption. And lastly, we're continuing to increase platform usage with our existing customer base with new functionality, innovation, and a digital direct strategy. Next slide. Slide 19 shows our growth expectations for FY21. New customer acquisitions in the second half of the year has created a momentum in the business, with these customers to have a material impact on revenues in FY21 and beyond. Revenue and ARR are both expected to increase by 21 to 30%, while EBITDA will improve 14 to 35% over FY20 figures. We're also increasing our R&D investment by about 8 to 15% to an excess of 9 million. Next slide. Before we finish, a quick recap on why Whisper exists. Put simply, we want to change the way the world communicates. Next slide. We can see a world in the near future where organizations can communicate like people. We want to humanize the way organizations communicate with their stakeholders. Next slide. We want to do this because we believe value is created when when people are engaged. Next slide. So our promise to our customers is that we enable them to master connection and engagement with other people at scale.